time bit since I played.
You never heard of Johann Ryan? My god, boy. He's probably the greatest man in history. And you don't know him? Or is it the world who has forgotten him?
Let's see here. Heavy doors blocking the path, a grip of the dying man seeks a note written by a name by a man named Johann Weyer. An orb is needed to enter the inner sanctum. Its shattered pieces lie scattered in the torture rooms. Okay.
Weyer was my pupil. My pupil. Yes, I do take pride in that. Is it so wrong?
It's been like a month since I played, so I apologize for, well, things start out that slow. Oh, okay. I remember this place, I think.
Ah, you again.
Yes,
not many orbs are left. They sometimes consume themselves. Operate.
I know this. I've been here already. I know this taste. A taste of Damascus rose obfuscating the truth in a dim age. They may sweep the traces from my memory, but my body remembers. These are cuts in volumes, even though my mind remains silent. They will be back. Oh, they will be back. Thank you.
something died inside of him that day. Watching that man slip away was more than his mind was willing to handle.
Just a little further.
It's like Orpheus descending into the underworld.
Are you hiding something?
What do you mean?
Never mind. Your intuition is remarkable.
I'm not sure I'm following.
It doesn't matter. It's just a myth after all.
I don't like those bird fluttering noises. Ooh. The shattered orb. All is lost. I must once again start over. Ever since I recovered the orb first founded by Agrippa, I've depended on it for my research. The incident with Wilhelm has made me most impetuous. Fearing a paucity of prisoners, I proceeded with the final ritual without proper foresight. The orb cracked and fell into 6 parts. I've tried everything, but have yet of mind to mend the thing. Unless I can think of a way to piece it together, I'll have to find another. There's still life in the pieces, and even if the orb isn't restored, I might be able to salvage some of its power for some other purpose. Centuries have passed in vain, and I begin to wonder if I will ever be able to see my love again. How much longer can I sustain my life? don't know what any of this means.
Banishment ritual is taking longer than expected, and we have to do what is needed. I spend my time helping out the prisoners. Being around these degenerates makes me ill. None of them even tries to face their punishment with any kind of dignity. They taunt me with their lies of innocence and their cowardly pleas of mercy. What can make a man fall so far from the grace of a civilized existence? They are all wicked men, and I remind myself of it constantly. Still, I am thankful for God sending these monsters our way, as they will serve as the instruments of my salvation. I try to study the different tools in the torture chamber and learn how to use them effectively. Last time was messy, and the effect suffered from my inexperience. When the next warding is to be performed, I shall be ready.
such filthy thought. Good men can safely cheer their departure as they are nothing but a burden to mankind. They shall not be missed.
These cells are meant to hold prisoners who are under treatment. The people you send for will end up here. Remember that the confinement itself works as a preamble to the torture, and you should pace yourself. Don't take anyone before they are ready.
Understood.
Sounds from the torture chambers are shuttled in through those pipes in the ceiling. Manage your victims well, and let one prisoner's pain instill terror in his cellmate.
Right.
How are things coming? Vile was a brave man, and dared to proceed where I did not. He unearthed a number of cavern temples, and gathered a whole collection of orbs. But, unlike every other finder since the fall of the Israeli, he was able to unshackle the horror you and I connected with the orbs. He used them, and was able to travel far and wide. Said he found a way to take me with him beyond the stars. But I was too afraid to come along. Seriously. And now all I can do is regret it.
Transom. back into place. Interesting. Thank you.
second chance. But so does Alec. That's why he keeps me here, as a hostage, hoping Vaya will reveal himself.
August 1839. I can't stop sweating and shaking. The warding ritual was not something of a sane mind. I did not even realize the dungeon was still in use. Alexander had his servants bring one of the prisoners, a murderer, he told me. Alexander made all the arrangements, but he said I had to perform the ritual in order to have the right effect. The shadow could be led astray by the blood of another. Killing the man would provide us precious time. What else could I do? Alexander said it had to be done. He is saving my life. I don't have the luxury of argument.
Talking to us now or back then?
Dad, goodness. You got the doors open? Good to go. I knew you could
do it. Oh, that's what I did. That's cool.
Thank you.
had gone too far. The man was suffocating as he could no longer breathe properly between the lashes. Displeased, he started to look for the Damascus rose oil. Well, this is new and different.
How much more, Baron? How much more am I supposed to withstand? Kill me, Orphan! Kill me!
This one. Prepare him.
Is it you, my love? I miss the most, or is it perhaps myself? I know what I've become. I'm not blind. I'm a monster to them, a demonic sultan perched on the dark mountaintop. There's little I can do to redeem myself. The Black Eagle fears me, and after Napoleon's defeat, it's only a matter of time before they demand my head on the platter. I must remove myself from this land. This time, it must work. If I can't return home now, I shall perish. There are quite a few things to be said about torture. I figured that the reaction I'd get from the victims would be highly individual. Thankfully, this is not the case. The humans have all have a very similar approach to dealing with physical pain and the terror of anticipation. I can't stress enough the importance of restraining the victims before proceeding. Even the most timid creature can break out in fits of violence for their strength to exceed their expected prowess. If proper care has been put into breaking the victim, this should not be a problem. It will also hinder the effect I'm after. The right steps are to take are, therefore, to strain while the victim is dazed. Proceed by presenting the form of torture you are about to apply, and then to continue with the actual act. The point of presentation is to infuse terror. The human mind is extremely efficient. It has triggered itself into greater fear simply by imagining it. While applying pain, make sure to avoid massive damage. I'll prove more efficient if the process can be sustained. Also, apply the pain in doses, if possible, with breaks so that the body sell. If you're whipping or cutting the victim, strike once. Wait for the pain to subdue, then strike again. As the body suffers, you'll continue to produce the vitae and saturate the blood with its properties. Only the careful performance will the victim yield maximum effect. If the victim doesn't behave as expected, it is likely all will be not for naught. Before this happens, feed them the amnesia drink and try again later. Sounds like we might have been tortured. Oh, come on. That's so dumb. kidnapper sat on her knees with her hands tied behind her back. She felt her hands being lifted and her body followed. Her shoulders gave away to the weight of her own body and cracked loudly. The suspended woman cried hysterically as the men contemplated their next step. What did I even accomplish? Truly grisly. The rapist hanged upside down, his tear soiled with blood flooding from his belly. The saw between his legs had lodged itself in the hip and went moving further. The men stepped back and waited for the victim to drain. So, gotcha, the sound pipes are right there.
Cradle is ready.
Good.
You're a man. How can you partake in this?
Is he all right?
He is one of the wicked. Don't pay his lies any attention.
I'm not a bad man. It was an accident.
He set a man on fire.
It wasn't my fault. Why won't anyone listen?
That's horrible.
Of course. We are dealing with monsters here.
His arsonist kept crying as they slowly loaded on and off the Imperator. It didn't take much to break him. They had meant for him to die, but the torture was working beyond their expectations. It wasn't the method, it was the arsonist. He was different from the others. They could make him forget again. Interesting. Yeah, once I figure out the puzzle, my mind is clear, huh? Thick liquid spread across his tongue. He swallowed excessively to consume every drop. He looked through the window at the widespread forest in the morning sun. Will this ever end? He thought. In the court, the Order of the Black Eagles spew their politics at each other while I sit quietly in place, willfully forgotten. Once in a while, someone will notice me and lose themselves in the silent cower before regaining their senses. They all know I'm the one and same Alexander who helped their fathers and grandfathers to found this great order. I've seen them take their father's places, and they too will grow old and pass away, while I remain the same, aged not by time, but by anguish. Agrippa channels the Wayer. Wayer taunts me from the other side. I trust him with my true reason for my efforts, and he still insists on me releasing Agrippa. How an enlightened man can such a lack of compassion and seat of power disgusts me. I can't bring myself to depart from Agrippa, as he is and has been for centuries my only link to the worlds beyond. Wayer claims he tries his best to release me from my banishment, but that he needs me to give him Agrippa first so that he too can help. If he could guarantee success, I'd happily oblige, but how am I to depart from him if my return might be denied? I know what they are capable of. I've seen their deception. Optimism is the most hopeless feeling, but I must retain it. I shall prepare for his release. To release Agrippa without killing him, Wayer told me to feed him a tonic made from a paralyzer, vitae, and tempter. The poisonous fungi should work as a paralyzer if I can find the internal gland from a large specimen. The choir seems to be fertile grounds for the sort. I should then be able to extract its contents with the proper tools. The vitae could be extracted as usual from any agonized human victim's blood. I just need large amounts to distill it properly. Remember to collect this during the next torture session. Tamter, on the other hand, will prove more difficult. I don't think he exists in this world. Simply writing the word with these letters looks wrong. I believe it's a property of the secretion in the water-dwelling cairn. I will have to address Wire with this, as he will have to supply me with a host. Also, a properly prepared well should suffice to contain it. The Tamter is the remains? The mucus on the remains?
15th of August, 1839. The blood wards are failing. The shadow beckons, and its cry disarms my actions. Hurry. No time to spare. You have to kill another. Alexander produces a knife. He wants me to cut the flesh. Do it. Save yourself. He is a murderer, Daniel. He is evil. A cold-blooded killer. Hurry. Alexander, you must let me be. I have to concentrate. Take the man, cut the lines, cut the flesh, watch the blood spill, let it come.
Please, I didn't do anything.
Take the man, cut the lines, take the man, cut the lines. Please, the man cried.
One life for another. You hear me, guardian of the orb? I did all this for you. Now, once more, withdraw your shadow from my domain.
Alexander, there isn't much time. I can feel it. We must act swiftly. I will do whatever it takes.
That's unpleasant. After the men had secured the prisoner, the ritual began. Excuse me.
Daniel, salvation. It used to be yours, but now you only seek misplaced revenge. How do you justify your violence? Is it for the greater good? Are you doing the world a service? It is you who caused all this pain and death. If you had accepted your fate and submitted to the orb when you first discovered it, none of this would have happened. It is curiosity in league with your selfishness that is killing us both.
Uh-huh. Okay, man, who's lived for unknown years? Well, this is not threatening at all. The forger stood absolutely still. The casket had been closed, but a faint light made its way inside. A myriad of spikes pointed at him, glittering as they waited for his body to slip for just a moment. His knee jerked, and he felt blood trickle down his leg. In pain, his head fell slightly forward. It took him a while to realize his eye had ruptured and begun to leak. sick clothes, why don't you? Unless if I must walk inside. Ow. Oh boy, the brass wool. The traitor did not know what to think of the brass wool as he was forced to enter it. Only when the heat of fire began to scorch his skin and cook his flesh did he realize this to be his tomb. His screams of pain echoed inside the brass chamber and traveled through the complex instrument which was the bull's head. Outside, the men could hear the brazen bull bellow.
mortal victim still during the procedure. They can be bound around the circumference or simply stretched across, tying limbs to the spokes and rim. All tools are by this point useful, and you may administer the torture in any way you like. But the forte of the wheel is the gaps. When you have decided that the victim shall die, you can smash their limbs with a hammer, making them fold in between the frame.
But they'll die. Too quickly, I mean.
No, don't worry. The human body is much more resilient. They can survive for days until they finally succumb.
Murderer's limbs were tied to the spokes of the wheel. They turned the wheel slowly, but with intent, so the rope secured around his legs stretched and cracked the bone. He no longer had the strength to scream. The two men looked at each other knowingly and took a hammer to the victim's chest in a final act of mercy. How nice, I can move it too. Sure.
Things coming. Incredible. You found Vaya's recipe. Then there might still be a chance. Listen carefully. Alexander is working on opening a gate, a door to another realm. It's where he wants to go. If you could put your anger aside, let him open the portal before you take your revenge. Let me pass the gate then.
Okay.
Please, find the ingredients and prepare the tonic Vaya describes. And do so before you barrier keeping you from the inner sanctum will only be breached for a short time. Unless everything is taken care of before mending the orb, you won't be able to save me. I see you have all the orb pieces you need. I know I have no right to ask anything of you. But if you could find it in your heart to gather the ingredients for Vyas Tarkar before attempting to mend the orb, there might still be a chance for you to save me. Please, my fate is in your hands.
I don't know why I keep on getting stuck on steps, and it's Nova City. garbage. So garbage. Hazel spent all summer in bed. He used to read her to her after helping father with his work. In his mind, he was like Sher Hazel-Zaid. And as long as he kept telling the story, that's the rest. Right, seriously? There's little left to say. I write slowly. If I'm fortunate, I'll fall asleep and time will pass without effort. I've begun to wean myself of my prison. When I first arrived, I felt like I was being buried inside a tomb, but now I feel the close walls comforting me. As long as I'm in here, there is no pain. The walls protect me from the outside. Even after there was one of the wardens dropped the key down the pipes. It gave me hope for a second, thinking I could escape, if only I could reach it from here. In my dreams, Alexander, I'm king. In my dreams, I best you and escape your clutches and return with all the knights of the realm carrying pistols and sabers. In my dreams. What's going on here? Why can't... Oh, shoot. this guy even come from? Hazel turned 15. She had lived 3 years longer than Dr. Tate had foreseen. Her parents had given up from the exhaustion and decided to have her committed for a permanent treatment at Canterbury Hospice, but she was still alive. She had embraced him and wished him a grand adventure in Algeria. Happened.
18th of August, 1839. Tonight, we will unlock the power of the orb and ultimately banish the shadow hunting me. I feel it closing in on me, and I fear for my life more than ever.
Oh.
Just outside Altstadt lies a small settlement where Zimmerman, a dairy farmer, lives with his wife and three children. Alexander was able to strike Zimmerman down without alerting the others. As he went to take care of the farmhands, I began to look for the children. We should have more than enough prisoners to finish the ritual now.
Crying had stopped, and he could hear a whisper coming from the cell. They're up to something, and he would have to punish them. Oh, come on, dude.
Here's the chance of collapse. The laboratory might be accessible now. Quickly, office ahead. And
what?
Then, whatever happens, get me through that gate. You're a good boy, Diana. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Daniel. No time for sitting around.
Aren't I supposed to get you free?
You're a good boy, Diana. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of.
Okay, what can I saw this head off with?
Shut up!
Yeah, isn't there a stall in here? Somewhere?
You can't come. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Daniel. No time for sitting around.
All his life he thought he was a good man. Terrible deeds were only committed by terrible people, like Henry Bedo, the bully in school, but now he'd seen what he himself could do.
girls escaped and I chased after her all the way upstairs. I hunted her down and... What is her life worth? How many lives can I take before I surrender my own? Sure, I would kill a murderer to save an innocent. But to kill an innocent? To save myself? A cold-blooded murderer.
Yeah, that's kind of what you are. Cried and struggled as he pulled at her arm. Her flowered Sunday dress ripped and she fell into the mud.
August
1839.
It's not fair. I'm not to blame. I've been manipulated by that demon. He played my guilty conscience and duped me into facing the shadow alone. That vile, conspiring
man.
He expects me to meet my death as he steals power beyond imagination. Alexander, I will kill you for what you have done. If only the shadow had caught me in London or Algeria, I wouldn't have to suffer this humiliation. You made me a murderer, a monster. And now, I merely await my death. I am too weak to press on.
I can hardly stand as my knees fail me. I cannot see as my eyes are dressed in tears.
I am as broken as the men I've tortured. If only I could wipe my fear away, as we did with them.
Frauding your brain, man. Orb chamber. He had turned angry. It was easy to take her insolence and make her live within the story. But she didn't deserve to die. Even he could see that.
I was wondering if you were going to show up. I see Agrippa convinced you to run some errands. Tell me, is everything nice and clear now? Am I the villain? Good and evil. Such comforting concepts, but hardly applicable. Are you so blind that you see no good in me or evil in Agrippa?
Oh, I can move.
There he is. Do you see him, Vaya? He deserves so much more. Please, help him. I know you can. Don't worry, Daniel. It will be all right.
That game was pretty fun. I feel bad about missing a bit of dialogue there. It's just, you know, in the past I've had experiences where villains take the prize away from you just as you're about to reach it. So I figured I'd try to get a grip of there in there as quickly as possible. DN 314. Cool. Well, thanks for watching. Have a nice night, you guys.